guys that want to say boo Nancy Pelosi.
Ooh.
And if we can start, we're going to have a picket line. If you can just follow, we're going to have a picket line as we're having chants. People are just coming off of work, and we want to let people know there's media out here. We want to let people know why we're here. Even though there has been this supposed ceasefire, we know what Israel's accomplished, what they're really trying to do, which is the ethnic cleansing, the apartheid of Israel, the state of Israel won't end with a ceasefire, but they're trying again to wipe out the Palestinian people, and we're here to resist that. So we're going to have some chants. Please follow with the picket sign. Free, free Palestine!
Also tonight at 5:30. And so again, any action, it's important.
important to come out, keep to the street, keep Palestine in the minds of people. So our next speaker is Gloria La Riva with the Party for Socialism and Liberation.
Thank you, Frank. When I was growing up, I remember I was a 5-year-old. And I saw, years after, the bodies of people. And I asked my parents what it was about. And they explained about the Holocaust and what happened to 6 million Jews and communists and the Roma people. Anybody who was not with the fascist Nazi regime of Germany. And I always wondered, how did it happen? How could it happen? Of course, I learned more about history, about the imperialist Germany and the U.S. letting this take place because they had other interests in other places. And that was called genocide because it was against the people. It was rightly characterized as genocide. Make no mistake, what's taking place against Palestine is genocide! And we have to push back and say that being against the Zionist state of Israel, which oppresses Palestinians as a matter of law and philosophy, is not being against Jews, because many Jews are in this fight with us. And I say that because it's a matter of humanity against a Zionist settler project that the United States makes possible without the billions of dollars to destroy homes and poison children with tear gas that destroys their lungs and bombs that blow into smithereens children and their parents and everything alive. And dark bombs that just fill your body with little pieces of metal. Without the billions of dollars from the United States, Israel would have fallen. Yeah. And Nancy Pelosi is a war criminal. Yeah. And Dianne Feinstein is too, and every one of those Congress people who send money while Israel was running out of weapons to kill more kids. So I think, you know what? And Barack Obama's a war criminal too. Because he could never manage to say something to condemn what was taking place. And we are the conscience, along with millions in the world, and the great Palestinian people who are resisting no matter what the cost. It's horrifying to think about the tens of thousands of people right now who have wounds, who have deep wounds, who have no medicine, doctors who are working night and day with nothing. And this is just the latest stage, everyone. So like Frank Lada has just said, this war is not over, and our war for justice is not over, and we must not rest. You know, we have our lives, but don't rest because the bombs have stopped right now. We have to boycott every little product. We're producing a leaflet with all the information. Don't go see Scarlett Johansson's new movie. I don't care how exciting it is. It's garbage. Don't buy SodaStream. Go to Cole Harbor and tell them, get rid of this project or I will picket you. We need to do that. We got to do a lot of things. And we got to demand of every institution to divest. We got a lot of work before us. But I want to say another thing. When you think of this system, I wrote a tweet the other day in the midst of, you know, what could I do at nighttime? And I said, this is the one reason what they've done to Palestine and want to continue doing to Palestine. This is the best reason of all for revolution, to overturn this system that just goes on profits and building bombs and using them to make more profits. Long live Palestine!
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 Long live
to tell the people what they're doing, how they killed kids, 300 kids out of 2,000 people. Where is the humanitarian? Where is the rights that the Palestinians deserve? Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Okay, you guys, we have another speaker. We have Richard from Answer.
With the people of Palestine, who have suffered so much for so long, it must end. And the Palestinian people have not been defeated. And I think this is important to say, despite all that suffering, Israel agreed to a ceasefire, and as Sameh said, it's not really a ceasefire, but they only agreed to it now because they could not crush the Palestinians in Gaza. And because they were afraid, they are deeply afraid that there was going to be a new massive uprising, a new massive defada in the West Bank and perhaps inside the 1948 borders too. And because they had become so isolated in the world, with millions of people demonstrating, with governments recalling ambassadors and condemning them in a way they've never been condemned before. And I just conclude by saying this, and what does that show us? It shows us that the reality is that the people make history. The people bring about the real changes. The people in the West Bank, the people in Gaza, the people in France and in South Africa and in Chile and in Venezuela and Cuba and here too. The people make history, and we have a lot of history to make. Thank you. Thank you, Richard.
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Sisters, what we're doing right now is, again, we're out here in solidarity with Palestine, and the reason we have to be out here again and again is to not hide Israeli crimes, not let Israel or the struggle, the Palestinian resistance, to fade away. And so the next action, if you happen to get one of these flyers for August 16th, the Block the Phone action, it's at 5 in the morning at the Israeli port. Many of the organizers here were there in 2010, and it was a very powerful action that Bay Area would not support Israeli apartheid any longer. So we have to be out here. It's at 5 in the morning. There's instructions, organizers, if you can contact down here, AROC, the Arab. You can go at info@araborganizing.org, but please look up the information for next Saturday to come out, because we have to show the world that the Bay Area, but also the U.S. in general, doesn't stand with the hypocrite politicians who continue to support the killing of children. Our next speaker is Frankie, again, a brother, native brother from here in San Francisco in the Mission, and has stood alongside this struggle for countless days. Please give it up, Frankie. Frankie.
Yeah.
My name is Frankie. I'm Navajo, Chinle, Arizona. I'm near the water, the Bitterwater Clan. My respect to the tribe of this area, the Ohlone people. This is a brother right next to me. His name is Luta. I'm going to speak for a moment, but he's going to offer a prayer song. So we're talking about genocide and occupation. Genocide, they never mentioned Native American people. Never. United States never mentioned about what the Indian boarding school did to the children, tortured the children, murdered the children, had mass graves of children. United States murdered, the U.S. Cavalry murdered at Bunini 300 women and children. There is a photo showing dead bodies in the snow. And when I see Palestine, I see the children's heads open. Little babies. That shit fucks my head up. That hurts. Our services go Bay Area people have a history of being anti-war activists from the Vietnam days. And don't be afraid to call those soldiers baby killers like we did back in those days. It is sad how our country does not care about any children. This war, any war, is a war on the people. It is a war on poverty, because we're spending so much money, they're having budget cuts in our education system. We have homeless people being evicted. People can't even eat. Labor unions on strike because they're not getting paid enough. They can't afford to live in this city. Taxpaying citizens. And it really hurts that when you see 60,000 plus children fleeing Honduras and El Salvador and Guatemala just to come to the United States. And why is it? It's because the United States occupied those territories and left them alone. And what now they have? Militias and gangs and cartels. When they killed Andy Lopez in Santa Rosa.
Yeah.
That officer got away with murder of a 13-year-old child. That is sad how we can't stop this war, but we can. We can call these politicians. We can blockade this boat coming in from Israel in Oakland. We must resist. Us Native people have been resisting for 520-plus years. And let me tell you, the American Indian Movement and West Chapter is in solidarity with the Palestine community. So is the Navajo people. Recently, our president went and visited Israel. That pissed a lot of us off. But also, we found out that the uranium that they're extracting from our land, poisoning our waters, is bombing the children of Palestine. They're using that stuff, and they're poisoning their lands and their children and their people. But the saddest thing is when they're bombing schools, they're bombing hospitals. They bombed the last electricity that Palestine had. And there was children on incubators that died because they took out their electricity. Now that is cruel and unusual punishment. That is inhumane. Not within the United States, but within the UN. And I'm going to let this brother speak and offer his songs and prayers. Thank you. Omatakia.
Good evening, relatives. My name is Vichakudu Kandalaya. I'm from Sinaloa. And I'm here representing the indigenous people of the Bay Area. And I'm going to be singing a song that calls out to our ancestors and the prayers to all the relatives and their lives lost here in occupied America and also in other occupied places around the indigenous world. Thank you.
Can I get a big